Hello, my name is Adam. I'm a part of the team at Vector that works very closely with the GeoLogger family, and in this video, we'll be talking about some of the features of the Vector Logger suite.
The first step will be to actually create the new project. So to do that, we're going to click on this red box here in the top left-hand corner of your window. And under Project, we're going to click on New, and we'll be prompted with this new configuration window. The next step will be to change the logger type, and I'll change mine specifically to the GL2400, as that's the specific logger I have sitting here on my desk. But for you, that might not be the case, so make sure to select whichever applies best. From here, we'll click on OK, and now we'll have a brand new template to play around in. I'm going to click on the Canned Channels tab here under the hardware banner on the left. And because I've only set up my hardware to support this simple tutorial, I have only connected my CAN channel 1. So I'll disable channels 2, 3, and 4, because even if I wanted to, we wouldn't be able to read anything off of them anyways. That's all the changes we'll make under the configuration tab. The next steps will be to save the project and actually write this new configuration to the logger. So, like many other applications, the Vector Logger Suite uses a star here at the top of the window to indicate that the project is unsaved. A simple Control S will fix that for us. And because it's a brand new project, we'll be prompted with the File Explorer. So I'll simply save this as GL2400_tutorial, as that's what it is. And an important note to always remember that the Vector Logger Suite will save these configuration files as .glc files. So I'll click on Save here, and I can now tell that the project has successfully been saved, as our title matches what we just saved it as. And now I'll actually write this configuration to the logger. So to do that, you should take the USB cord that should have came with your logger and plug it into the front panel of the logger. And you should hear a chime go off with your Windows device to indicate that a new USB device has been found. I can tell that our logger has been identified, as this Write to Device button here has now lit up where it was previously grayed out. So I'll click on it, and our destination drive matches what is to be expected, as it says GL2400 here. So I'll click on OK. And now it's going to tell me that the memory card on the logger has to be wiped before we write this new configuration. I'll say yes, as I'm not saving anything important on this existing SD card, but this is an important note to be mindful of, as there's no way around this. Once you save a new configuration to a logger, the existing SD card needs to be erased. So now it's going to tell me that the configuration has successfully been written to the memory card, and we're safe to eject the USB cord. So I'll select OK here. And now, if you look at the logger you've just hooked up, you should see that the LED that's next to the USB label should be blinking. This tells us that the USB is safe to remove, so I'll do that now. And you should hear a chime go off from your Windows computer telling you that the USB has been disconnected. From here, the remaining LEDs will be flashing back and forth, and this tells us that the logger is actually writing this existing configuration to its hardware. So once it's done with that, we should see that LED 1 will simply be blinking. And this is because we didn't change any of the LED settings inside the Vector Logger Suite. And the default is simply that LED 1 will blink. Once this is the case, the logger is actually in logging mode. And if we were to push messages across the CAN bus, the logger would actually be reading them. Since we're done with that, to exit logging mode, simply plug the USB cord back into the front panel of the logger as you did the first time. And you'll hear that chime go off that tells you that the USB port has been recognized, and it says scanning for logger devices, if you could read fast enough. So once that's the case, we'll swap to the logging data tab here at the top of your banner. And from here, we'll click on select, and under attached hardware, your logger should show up here. So I'll click on this, and boom, there's our measurement file. It is currently 3:15 p.m., and the last log ended at 3:14:59, so that tells us that this log is fresh, and we only record for about 30 seconds. It's possible that if you record over a period of several hours, then you could have many measurement files, but again, because it's only about 30 seconds, it all fits in one. And that's it. I hope this cleared up some of the confusion around actually recording a log file and helped you understand the Vector Logger Suite a little bit better.
That's everything I wanted to talk about in this video. I hope you found my explanations to be helpful, and I hope you learned something new. Thanks for watching.